So take what you want, take what you can, take what you please, don't give a damn, ask for forgiveness, never permission. Take what you want, take what you can, take what you please, don't give a damn, it's in the blood and this is tradition.
Get more of it. Thank you. I don't believe in love any longer, because love don't believe in me. She's out of reach, like a coin in the street, tired of being on your feet. Hopeless devotion, a fickle emotion, condition, a fiction of yours. I bet over under, I'll hopelessly wonder, if not here, then where will I go? I don't believe in justice no longer, because just wasn't made just for me. How can I help when my brain named itself? I'm so smart, but why do I need this grave explanation, narrated translation, vocation for opening wide? Masochistic, linguistic, and more like a mystic. The magic trick lives when you die.
I would have followed all. Thank you. Thank you.
maybe things will never be the same. But I'm not sure, but I really loved the way they were before. And I don't know if I'm capable of loving anything anymore. My stomach's even open, I'm anxious to my knees. I toss and turn at night and hope that it's not a disease, that it's hereditary. Lord knows it's scary. I think I might have made you into somebody like me. I wish that I could smile more, and maybe you did too. I don't believe in anything unless I look at you. I know I should be better. I know that I should see it. I know that it's imperative I get enough to eat. So why do I feel helpless when there's tons of help around? And why do I feel lost when I'm never left unfound? And maybe it's the internet or strangers at the store. I just feel like I don't belong here anymore. I'm sweeter than my mother, but stubborn is my dad. And I thought I'd be the person the little me never had. The walls are caving in now and somehow getting wider, and there's chaos and never-ending silence, and there's cries that come from hunger and defiance. I'm a giant. And I'm lonely. But it's not me who's supposed to hold me.
part I've ever said. I started doing that on this tour for the first time ever, and it's funny because I was really nervous about it at first. It's like, God, what if I draw something fucking terrible? What if I was like completely blank one night and I like draw a line and I'm like, in front of like tens of thousands of people, and everyone in the audience is like, oh, a circle. Cool, Halsey. But the reason that I do it, right, is because I try to make every show have these moments that are so unique to this specific night, right? And I do the drawing at every show, but I never draw the same thing twice, ever. So that means that what I did right there, whether it's good, whether it's bad, whatever, it's capturing the way that I feel right now with you, which is a feeling that will never be replicated ever again. And I think that you guys deserve it. I think that every crowd deserves it. That moment that is just so intimate and so unique and bonded to just us. And I gotta be honest with you guys. You guys are such an amazing fucking crowd. I wish I'd do something better. You deserve like the fucking Mona Lisa. But in my defense, I only had like 3 minutes to do it. Yeah. I'm 27 years old now. Which is crazy because what the fuck? And I haven't toured in the United States in almost 5 years. Which is absolutely fucking crazy. So the last time that I saw you guys, some of you guys, my life looked a lot different. For starters, I have a baby now. Which is like, I know, I can't believe they let me leave the hospital with him either. It's insane. I remember getting in the car right after he was born and sitting in the back seat being like, okay. Fuck. It's just me now. I gotta figure this out little by little. One of the things that I did was in the drive home, I held his face in his car seat the entire time because I was so afraid he was gonna stop breathing. And if any of you guys are parents in the crowd, you know exactly what that feeling is like. But being a musician, you know, it gave me a lot of practice, weirdly, for being a mom. And I know that sounds like it doesn't make any sense, but I'll explain why. When I make an album or I make a song, I'm so attached to it. And I want it to mean the world to whoever hears it. And, you know, I have these expectations for it. How I want it to make you feel, what I want you to think it means, what I want it to represent. But then once I release it and it goes out into the world, it's not mine anymore. It's yours. And it takes on a life of its own. It develops its own personality and it grows into this thing. And I have to watch it and I have to go, oh my God, I made you, but now you're something else. You know? And in a weird way, that really prepared me for being a mom. So I really want to thank you guys for that. Because I'm a really good one. I'm a really good mom. And when my son grows up, he's going to have millions of people to thank for that. So, thank you. You know, before I had my son, my life was not, it was not so pretty of a picture. And I had everything that I could ever want in life. I had achieved everything that I wanted in my career. But my personal life was an absolute fucking shit show. It's okay, you can laugh. It was. And now I get to go on stage and I get to sing songs about that time in my life. And I get to think about how different my life looks now. And I just want to tell you that if your life looks more like the shit show that mine was, it's not going to stay that way. It's going to get better. And it might get better and then get worse again, and then get better again, and then get worse again, and then get better again. But it will always end on the positive, I promise you that. This song is called 100 Lives.
Find some. God. Voices in there hitting that high octave. I see you.
Alright, you better get those lights back out because I love this one for you.
Darling, don't you cry. If I swore the light,
What time is it?
Because then you get the guitar pick and I don't have to embarrass myself. like by throwing something in front of you guys. It's somebody else's birthday too today, actually. Do you guys know whose birthday it is tonight? I don't know where she is. She running around somewhere? Gang? Crew? Someone? She's out here by myself. Okay, well, we can't find her, but it's the thought that counts, so we're gonna sing happy birthday because today is the birthday of my amazing support act, Biba Doobie. We're gonna sing happy birthday to B, okay? Incredible group of humans up here playing music with me, huh? Where do I want to start today? I'm going to start with Liv, because I never start with Liv. Hold on. It's a tradition that I say something ridiculous about them, so let me think for a second. Okay. Live. What do I got for you today? Ah, fuck it, you guys are right. Drums. A man. I'm just kidding, guys. Give it up for Harry. Harry. Woo! I had a bunch of like amazing things planned to say tonight, and then you guys caught me so off guard with all that cheering. I can't fucking remember anything I was gonna say. Which is probably a good thing, because sometimes at my concerts I talk a lot, and usually some dude in the back who's like had like 17 beers is like, shut up! I can't see you sing, not hear you fucking talk! And in all fairness, he's right, you know. Fair point. I don't get the chance to see you guys a lot, so I have a lot of shit on my mind, and I want to tell you, and I want to talk to you, so forgive me, I'm so sorry. How many of you guys here are happily coupled up in a relationship? How many of you guys are single? Fun crowd. I don't know what happened, but as we started getting older, more and more people at Halsey concerts started being in happy relationships, and I'm just wondering where I went wrong.
my music is not supposed to be for people in healthy relationships. It's for the rest of us, you know? I'm just kidding. I'm in a healthy relationship. I love it. It's awesome. All the other toxic shit, I promise you, is not what it's cracked up to be. So if you get near it, run far the fuck away. However, for the next 4 minutes or so, we can pretend, right?
Calling me a bitch again. There's a guy back there to the garden state, and he told me that we make it to.
So, there comes a point in every show, right, where we have an option. I can either play two more songs, or I can play six more songs. I can play two more songs, or I can come back and I can do the most disrespectful, obnoxious encore that you've ever seen in your life. It just keeps going. And I want you guys to think for a second, right? Because I've got a couple hits. And I haven't played them yet. So what we could do is I could play two more songs. Or I can give you a absolutely fucked up bananas slam, 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 to finish out the rest of the set. Now, are you tired? Okay, good, me neither. You guys down here in the front, if you know the words to this chorus, I want you to scream them as loud as you fucking can. And if you're at the back, you know that I want to hear you scream them as loud as you fucking can.
You do not!
guys want to hear, I promise you, but first, we're gonna do something a little weird, okay? Is it okay with you if we do something a little weird?
Bound to you when your heart was broken. I'm never back to swim with you.